Hi everyone, thanks for tuning in. I just wanted to show off sort of a companion prop to the Back to the Future shoes. This was a 2015 Marty McFly hoverboard from Back to the Future 2 that I made for my Marty costume for Fan Expo 2015. And what I wanted to do with this hoverboard was not so much make a 100% accurate hoverboard. I didn't want to make it out of really, really heavy materials or anything like that. I wanted it to be convention friendly. You know, if I bumped into somebody, I wasn't going to be worried about it. And just try to keep it really simple. I wasn't trying to spend a ton of time on it. And so while it's not 100% accurate, you know, from kind of a distance and for convention use, it's pretty good. So I got some of these digital files for the top and bottom graphics from some really cool users on the our members of the RPF. And they've been awesome in sharing their artwork. And it actually kind of started, it was about a year and a half ago, I'd gotten some of these Vacuform magnet pads off eBay. And I was like, oh, you know, one day I'll make a hoverboard. And I never really kind of got around to it. And then when 2015 started coming around, I knew I really wanted to make that costume. So I started planning out the board. I got all the dimensions of the board from the RPF. And so instead of using wood for this particular project to try to make it a little bit lighter, it's actually several layers of Sintra laminated together. So Sintra is like this laminated foam. It's a high density foam with sort of like a plastic sheeting on the top. And it, you know, it carves very nicely. You can actually heat it and bend it. And what I did was I took, I think some half inch layers and then some quarter inch layers and laminated them together so that I would end up with a 1 inch thick board. And then what I did to try to make it a little bit lighter is inside I used a circular cutting tool on the drill and basically cut out these sort of big 2 inch circles in like a honeycomb pattern, and that lightened up the board significantly. And then I just made sure that any sort of screws that were going to be going in to mount the magnet pads weren't going to go through any of the holes. And then also I wanted to make sure that the foot pad could still rotate as well too. So in terms of accuracy, this part's fairly accurate. It's kind of a 2 inch wide strip of nylon. It's bolted to a couple layers of Sintra, and then there's pink fur that's just glued onto the nylon. And what I did was I sandwiched in a couple of thin metal wires inside so that I could shape this nicely so that it wasn't flopping around all the time. I added the hole here in the front of the board, and that's the hole that the handlebars actually go into when Marty steals it off that kid in the park. This is a slightly inaccurate detail, but I thought it still looked really cool. I got some of this prismatic pink tape just off eBay, and in the original hoverboards, they used a lenticular material for the top, and they actually like cut out all these separate pieces and glued them down. And I think for some of the Hero boards, they use that material on the edge as well too. That material was really, really hard to find. I didn't really want to go for that kind of accuracy. Again, I just wanted to make it look pretty good from a distance. So this sort of prismatic tape vinyl graphic worked out really well. And then the people that made the graphics for the top obviously made the bottom as well too. So I just took that out to a local print shop, had that printed out on an adhesive material and just stuck it on the board. That was pretty straightforward. The magnet pads, I prepped them, trimmed them. They were not trimmed at all, and the shape wasn't super accurate. So what I did was I went in and kind of accurized the, you know, made a little bit more accurate in terms of the shape, and then used these black drywall screws, which is kind of what's seen on the regular board. For these pads, I got some of this sort of brushed metal vinyl, and I used a circle cutter to cut those out and stuck those down as well too. So pretty simple prop, but you know, pretty effective for Back to the Future fans, and yeah, it worked out great for the costume. So thanks very much for tuning in, and I hope you enjoyed it.